Now, what did we think of that, eh? I felt something has been missing from our episodes for a while now, and I don't know for certain that it's been this, but I can say that making it was a blast. At the very least, it should add a well-needed sense of continuity and just a dash of pomme de terre. But enough about the intro. Kutam Melunudis Wamid, you beautiful people. Welcome back to Channelglazes, and more specifically, the Trade Depot, where we see the humans have once again graced us with their smell. Rimtar's with them. Has been with them for weeks now, despite the trading being over. I left trader required on in the depot, didn't I? Whoopsie! Sure, she's fine. Yes. She loves being our broker. The clink of coin, the art of the deal, the grackle. Fun fact, a grackle is a sweet little black bird and not the big hairy cave monster I envisioned before purchase. Big disappointment. I'll tell you what wasn't a big disappointment, though. Luki has petitioned to become a full citizen. Just in time to get attacked by a rampaging group of dingo-men. Gave better than he took, if you ask me, though. Yes, his hand's pretty banged up, but let me tell you, he's a demon with that instrument of his. Yes, he's already proven his worth to Channelglazes. Oh, where's he gone? His hand's still torn open. Has the hospital run out of supplies? No. And it's definitely still a hospital. And we've got doctors assigned? Yes. Sad to say this goes on for quite a while. Many of you are probably shouting, the screen doesn't update while you're on it. So we'll just skip to after I stop talking about it. I would say after I figure it out, but that was 30 seconds ago for script writing phlegm, so you'd get no video. I think it would pack quite a punch, see? He's brandishing his earthenware Luke like a true warrior. Marvellous. What's our crockery-wielding guardian up to now, I wonder? Ah, praying to an imaginary deity. Disappointing, but I think we can let it slide. Oh, meditating on fortresses now. He's multitasking. Now, I know we're a dwarven fortress and we're going for the whole traditional diggy-diggy-hole aesthetic, but our three humans have all just been such fantastic characters. I think I might have to spend some time in the archives and discern exactly how these scrawny head knockers do what they do. We most certainly need more of them, and the prickleberries are just not doing the trick. I've found another one of those stinking, slinking dingo-men. The squad is on the way. Come into my fortress and attack my humans, will you? Where's Kolkol? Get him! Yes, dead. Nothing more than you deserve. Bleh. No. It would appear all the commotion has agitated a flock of giant ravens, and one of them has torn into our poor Kolkol. Ah! I bet she threw the fight on purpose to play the pity card. I'm on to you, you freaky little... See, she's fine. What hideously mangled individual could carry themselves back to hospital? Well, other than Catton. Here she is, lying unconscious and injured. I know a gentle catnap when I see one. Heh heh, she feels restless after resting. Silly dwarf fortress. Well, she's up and about now, and perhaps I should apologise to her. Permanent motor nerve damage and both arms required suturing. Doesn't appear to have slowed her down any... Damn it. Catton's chirpy optimism is catching. You've just been mauled by Sky Beast, you fungus brain nitwit. The sane thing to do would be to spend the next month gibbering in the corner, not sneaking drinks direct from the still. Wait, she's... attending a meeting? On the surface? She's heading off to where she downed that dang dingoman. Perhaps to say a few words. Let's listen in. Ah, how very pleasant. She's still looking for that meeting. I believe that means specifically with Thikut, our expedition leader. Though you wouldn't know it from the way she's meandering round and round the fortress. Let me just cut to when she finds Thikut's office. Ha! Quite the meeting! What was that, 2 seconds? No, I suppose with the time dilation it was probably more like half a day. We never talk about how weird time is in this game, do we? When a breastplate can be completed in the same time it takes a dwarf to eat a sandwich. Just be thankful it isn't 1-to-1. We'd still be unloading the wagons. Kolkol should be fine anyway. I'll take her out of the military and let her get back to making a damn nuisance of herself. Perhaps Thikut will appreciate a little help with the plant gathering. Certainly a thought. Hello, Your Highness. Don't mind the pile of assorted corpses. Did you have a nice trip? No, I can't imagine you did. Thikut was in her office, but I think, yes, there you go, you've got her. The world's the same as ever. No surprise there. On with the lack of surprises, we're asking for drinks and a little thread. Yes, because I was worried by the stocks in the hospital. No, we don't actually need anything. Then Relic Shimmered are asking for headwear and footwear, which just makes me want to sell them belts. And that's it. All done. I think she'll probably... Yes, there she goes. Straight into the Candies of Wire to listen to Emtha's poem and... Unfortunately to witness Kolkol fighting over scraps with one of the mangy moggies. So sorry, Your Highness. Trading will be a simple affair once again. However, we shall be dipping our toes into the murky pool of slave trading. We caught a bunch of those dingo-men, and after saving a breeding pair, I'm not having the rest hanging around making the stockpiles look untidy. So yes, off they go, and no, I don't feel the tiniest bit bad. A script-writing phlegm here again. No, I didn't know, and don't you spoil it for those that don't know either.
It's not like they lay eggs.
So we'll just let the dwarves start gathering up all the things, and then I'll send Rimtar down to start haggling. We're following Thikut right now. I noticed that she was looking kind of blue, and she's far too instrumental to the running of the fortress for that to continue. So I can see that she wants to acquire something, more like half the bloody fortress. She's looking to be extravagant. Not sure how I feel about that. And she wants to be with family, none of whom live at the fortress. At least we could possibly deal with the want for martial training. Maybe get a second squad filled out with the fortress's administrators. Just to ensure they don't end up on the business end of a troll by mistake. Oh, do be careful going out, Thikut. Wait, was that a dingoman? I guess not. No, come on. There are other dwarves that can drag the water buffalo back into pasture. No need to trouble yourself. What in the name of me is all that racket? Oh dear. It would appear we got infiltrated by another pack of dingo-men. Not to worry, though. I'm sure the dwarves will all have it in hand. Script-writing phlegm here. Yes, all right, you can all stop laughing. So, it would appear that the dwarves refused to sell sentient beings. So when we sent those cages to the depot, the dwarves dumped the contents in favour of a beautiful, unburdened cage. Releasing the sodding dingo-men into the fortress again. Mass murder and child labour, all dandy, but you draw the line at selling people. Really, Mr. Adams?
Wouldn't believe it if I hadn't seen it with my own eyes. Our very own Queen Ervad. She beat it to a bloody pulp with her bare hands. It's a pile of dingo-y bits outside the Candies of Wire now. I tell you what, don't want to get on her bad side, mine no.
With all the blood and violence our poor dwarves have had to deal with recently, it should surprise nobody that moods are not at all where I would like them to be. Thikut is a particularly stressed individual, but she's not that much worse than the majority of the others. So,
What I've done is get the dwarves to roll a couple of good barrels of food and drink into the candies of wire, set up a burrows that encompasses this floor and the small temple only, and I plan to let the grumpy little sods get their party on. So far it's not going particularly well. I don't know where everybody is, but I do know that Kolkol is following Thikut around and moaning incessantly at her. Hopefully that won't continue. I really want Thikut to let her hair down. There we go. Much better. We've got a big group of dwarves just relaxing socially in the tavern now, and joy of joys, Kolkol is in her bedroom, sleeping like a baby. We'll have to send somebody in to clear up the mess when she wakes up, but that is a problem for the future. For now, we can just be glad that the mood in Channelglazes is on the rise. Ah, damn, spoke too soon. No, don't bother Thikut, she's going to sleep! Yes, that's it. Go back to your own room and climb up onto the cabinet. I did mention she was 2 eels short of a pie. At least the party and the candies of wire is continuing well. Ugh, what a mess. If we'd gotten some more migrants already, we wouldn't need to waste all this time de-stressing. My kingdom for 10 to 12 more stout little bodies to jam into some manufacturing processes. Oh, this is beyond ridiculous. We're going to need to keep that wretched dwarf busy somehow. Whilst everybody else is enjoying the downtime, these two are in a tight spiral, destination depression, and the most infuriating part of all of this is I'm not even sure Kolkol speaks dwarvish. I can't help you if you don't... I don't understand! Yes, I thought not. No, whoopsie. Seems like the drinks ran out and I didn't notice. Well, I guess that means party over. Go on, get yourselves gone, my little beauties. Well, it wasn't a complete waste of time. The mood in general has improved, but Thikut was my focus, I'll be honest, and, well, things didn't go as planned. Ah, Emtha's getting that poem out regardless, it would seem, silly human. Oh, and here's something I forgot to mention. The giant thrips in our cage here actually gave birth to twin babies. Our first birth in the fortress. Isn't that lovely? Not sure how, precisely. Not like she had any eggs, but still a lovely occasion. Any suggestions for names, just pop a comment in below. Oh, finally! It's only taken 2 bloody years, but migrants have finally made their way here to Channelglazes. Now, I was a little busy when the message popped up, so we missed seeing the majority walk in. But it's not an issue, because I noted the migrants brought this duckling with them. Allow me to just bestow it with a rudimentary sentience, and provide it with the knowledge of my existence. There. Now we can follow it as it waddles off to the temple to prostrate itself in a healthy fear of the deific. Look at its little legs go. Jumping off the roof of the trade depot. Oh, he's trembling. Lovely. Oh, look, the humans are here. Still haven't opened up the doors to the caverns, so they aren't having much monster hunting to do. But never mind. Right, I'd better remove my influence from that duck and let the dwarves send him up to pasture. Well, maybe just the second thing. Oh me, I'm naughty. In less silly news, here we have Channelglazes' first dwarven child. A little Cubuck here joined us in the migrant wave, and now he's helping out in the near-surface stockpile that I still need to dismantle and move. Ah, so much work to do. Good lord, look at the mess of dwarves. I think one central staircase might not be doing the trick anymore, nor the single thin corridor above. More dwarves means needing more space. Who'd have thunk it? Ah, well, we'll get to work soon. Oh, how precious. He's playing make-believe with the cut gems. I wonder what he'll be when he's all grown up. I'll be watching you with great interest, little one. Cor, look at this. We ordered up some more bedrooms. Well, we needed them. And they've absolutely flown up. Look at this efficiency. Can't moan about that. By me, no. Still got a handful more to do, but with this formidable workforce, I'm not concerned at all. Summer is upon us, and so the humans make their way into our fortress. Well, we've been preparing for them. I've had the dwarves turning bone into figurines. We had something of a surplus of that specific material, and it seemed silly for it to just go to waste. In all honesty, I wish the humans would just stop coming. It's becoming a real struggle having enough goods to trade with two separate caravans. And at least the dwarven caravans from Relicshim would bring us clothing we can actually bloody wear. And the dwarves go through the trade entrance by the brass knobs on my bath taps. Would you stop bringing your filthy animals to our fortress proper? We've only got the one tile-wide corridor upstairs. Maybe it's time to close off the old entrances. Anyway, we're going to leave the humans setting up. I've been working on an issue we had during the party, and I want to show it off before we part for another fortnight. And here it is. Welcome to the new food and drink preparation and storage area for the candies of wire. I've been meaning to consolidate all consumables deeper into the fortress for a while now, and running out of everything at the party really underlined the need. Oh, and ignore the fact I've set up two stills. The top one should be a kitchen, but you know what it's like when you've been manifesting for hours. All the words start to bleed together. Here's the candies of wire with the two new staircases at the back. Form undiminished and function very much improved. Can't wait to see it used. And that's it. Another journey to the dimension of destiny completed. Another step on the road to cultural and spiritual dominance, stepped on. As usual, it has been my pleasure to entertain you today. Thank you so, so much for your kind words of encouragement and joy, and I wish you all a very fine day. Anous Eshon, my friends. Anous Eshon. Hello, me again. I was tinkering with the idea of having Kolkol ask for you to like and subscribe, but as hilarious as that would have been, I'm not certain the message would have been clear. So yes, like, subscribe, comment, perform elaborate folk dances, all that good stuff.